Good morning, I am Nagvini Envy, Assistant Professor of English. In today's class, I am going to briefly explain scene 1 and 2 from the act of the act 3 from Every Man in His Humour by Ben Jonson, prescribed by the University of Mysore to the second year BA, third semester, CVCS course, optional English, paper 3, Elizabethan Theatre. In the Act 3, Scene 1 and 2, Matthew, Wellbred and Captain Bobadil meet. Betty Akhtar, Matthew speaks ill of Downright and Downright doesn't like it because Wellbred doesn't like it because Downright is his half-brother. Edward Nowell and Stephen join them. Nowell talks about the letter written by Wellbred. And Edward conveys that his father has read the letter and has appreciated the has not appreciated the content. Nantanda patta odidare ari bejaragide anta heltane. Amele he introduces Stephen to the group. Nodi illivarigu introduce madilla anna karkondu hogiddene alli ellu jothe party madlikke adre innu patle madsilla. Stephen displaces rapier. Bobadil tells him it is not worthy his sword. ತನ್ನ ರೇಪಿಯರ್ ಕೊಂಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಾರ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾನೆ ಬೊಬಾಡಿಲ್ಗೆ. ಬೊಬಾಡಿಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ ಅದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿದಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಾರ್ ಇನ್ನೂ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಹೀ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ವಿಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ವೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್. ಹಿ ಡಸಂಟ್ ರಿವೀಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ಲೋಸಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಡ್ವರ್ಡ್ ನೋವೆಲ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ನೌ ಸ್ಟೀಫನ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ರಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಾರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಸ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ನೌ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಾರ್ ಕನ್ಫೆಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ. And Brainwar informs Edward about his father's arrival and intention of spying on him. Edward tells everyone about his father and they all hurry to back to Noel's residence. They take Brainwar along. At Keitley's warehouse, he inquires Cash about a client. He does not want to leave but has to go to Justice Clement's house on urgent business. Kaitle manele namu gottu cash avana nambi ittkondidane kelsakke avanuge hogu ishta illa adre urgent Clement manege hogbekagide avaru. So hogodik munche he decides to trust cash with the safety of his warehouse. He entrusts the safety of his warehouse to cash and he tells him to send a messenger without fail if Wellbred and his companions arrive. Achatige Cobb enters grumbling about fasting days. At the same time Wellbred also enters with his companions. Now Cash wants to send a messenger to Keitley but he doesn't find any messenger. And in these scenes, what do we learn? What do we know? These scenes describe a society where superficial morality, social morality and trust issues are important than real inner concerns or feelings. Jonson indicates the real human nature underlying beneath the superficial social morals. Andre olagondu horagondu. ಹೇಗೆ ಸಮಾಜದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು ಅನುಸರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಜಾನ್ಸನ್ನ ಈ ಮೂರು ದೃಶ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನೀವು ಪುಸ್ತಕವನ್ನು ಓದಿ. ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹೂಮ್ ಡಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಡಿಸ್ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಫುಲಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವೆಲ್ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹೂ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಎಡ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಹೂ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿಸ್ಗೈಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ವೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್. What is the strict instruction of Keitley to Cash before leaving warehouse? To inform about Wellbred's activity. What does Edward Nowell convey to his friends? He conveys that his father has arranged for his higher education, that he is in love with Bridget, that his father has arranged a masquerade, that his father is aware of the contents of Wellbred's letter is the answer. who tells Stefan that the rapier is worthless. Bobadil are downright. Bobadil. I think you have understood the explanation of this session. If you have any doubt or query, post it in the comment box and consult your teacher. Take care. Bye.